Day two at the unusual shaped water feature with the bitumen painted surface. Ah, beautiful, thank you very much. Right, as you can see from here, look, got a bit of bleed through. It's quite surprising actually that it's managed to bleed through the first resin coat that I put on, which I felt everywhere, and I wouldn't have, you know, started the job if I'd have known that, you know, if it was obvious that, you know, a bit of wet bitumen there, I'd never have started it. I'd have put more resin over it or a primary layer of glass. But it's come through anyway during the time that it took yesterday and to get here this morning. So the fix, I can't trust this, it's actually coming off on my finger, so it can't be trusted, so it's gonna have to be re-glassed. I should just re-glass that. I may as well just put a new piece of glass over all of that side, one at the top there where it's bled through, good size patch over that, resin wash that where it's not sticky down in that corner. This is just what's happened. The cover has failed, no surprise really, it was absolutely hammering it down yesterday after I left here. See, it's worn through where there's a plank there and a bit of wood there, and it's just worn against the edges in the wind. I'm not calling the customer for it, he couldn't get any boards to ply this out, so it is what it is, it'll dry out. So a couple of little bits of rectification to do, no great drama at all. So I'll crack on, get that done, and then when I'm completely satisfied that everything, all that bitumen is going to be held back, then I'll put the flow coat on. I've been looking at this left hand side and I'm thinking to myself, what's happened here that this side there's barely any resin bleed, none to be concerned about whatsoever, yet on this side with the same amount of resin, same amount of hardener gone in, the bitumen bleed has occurred. Now the only thing I can think of to myself is, you know, this was done first, that was the first section that I laid up in that video, then I did this one and then smashed that section out in no time at all. When I left it just started to rain. I'm like, well, okay, well that's going to put the cover to the test if the fiberglass gets wet, you know, cured or not. I'll deal with that this morning. But a little bit of rain. So what I'm thinking is, in the lag time of when I left, that rain and that damp atmosphere slowed this all down from hardening, and then the bitumen managed to bleed through the uncured fiberglass, whereas that went off in nice warm, I mean it won't have got cold, but as I've said a million times before, damp atmospheres do retard this resin from setting, it slows it down. So I think that's what's happened. Like I say, no great drama. What I don't want to do is take a risk and think to myself, right, yeah, flowcoat or seal that back, because it's just very slightly coming off my finger. And to be honest, flowcoat probably would seal it. Another coat of resin, definitely going to seal it, but I'm going to glass over it just to make sure. The last thing I want is to have made any promises to the customer that, yep, it's all going to be right, no problem at all. Get myself off to another 3 or 4 day job somewhere else, yeah, and then have a phone call. Matt, can you explain what's going on here? You know, you promised me. Well, I'm on a 4 day job at the minute. Well, that's no good to me. I want my pond full of water, thanks very much. Or if I went on holiday, hang on a minute, Matt, you're on holiday on my money and my pond ain't working properly like you promised. So as always, no risks taken with this game whatsoever. Not in the business of risks. I mean, I've known about these things happening before. Could I have reasonably predicted or expected this to happen. No, otherwise I would have dealt with it in a different way and I would have foam lined it. See, this section was telling me that my method was sound and it was working because there's no bleed through. The bleed through has happened in those corners here, along this top, along that top, and down in that corner. Now this damp sort of cooler environment explanation is ringing true with me, because in that corner it's going to will have been cooler. In the corners it's always cooler, and the vapors that sit down at the bottom, even though this is quite shallow, they retard the curing process as well. So I think it's a combination of things that has forced my hand into now dealing with a situation that's been put in front of me. I've explained everything to the customer. There's absolutely nothing to worry about. This is my new approach. And he said, Matt, I really appreciate it. You know, thanks. But, you know, that is just the way I roll. It's no good being paid and having to give a refund and all that associated miva and the embarrassment of it not doing and not performing exactly as I promised. But she'll be good. She'll be good. Just a little bit of rectification to do in these areas and we're fine. Okay, what I've done, I've put 1% hardener in 25% worth of what 1% would normally go in, which is a full bucket. So it's going to go off rather rapid. And if my predictions are right, it will go off that quick that this bitumen cannot bleed through it again, because it just won't have time. Then it's got to get through another layer of resin that's going over this, another layer of glass, another layer of tissue. Good luck to it. Be interesting to see if there's any resin bleed onto the roller. Resin bleed? Bitumen bleed, I mean. Jesus, the colour of that resin already. Because it's got a ton of hardener in it. Now, just to be sure, at the bottom section where the bitumen bled through, extra two layers on that. There's already an extra two layers on that.
Appreciate it, no problem, mate. Jesus, it's even getting through that. Have some more layers of glass over it. Got to be careful turning my back on that with it being mixed up so fast. Now this isn't coming off to my fingertips, so this will just be super fast resin and a tissue. That's the worst of the area. Okay. good with that. Name that tune in one. Straight, you twat. Sunday morning, just please go right for me on a Sunday morning. Fuck's sake, come on. Thank you. gone. Can't do anything further with that now, so just let it set.
That acetone my tools are in. That's going to be set solid by the end of the day. So, just seeing how these things work. Right, let's see how it responds to that. Of course, I'm not just going to go blasting the flow coat on. I'm going to be double checking it. Just make sure we're good. Cool. Right, let's take a break, have that nice cup of tea.
very rarely when I do it like this with a brush and all by hand and not with a roller. I'm telling you now, this is a smoothest finish you could possibly get on it. This is, a roller doesn't give you a flat finish like this. It's like enamel, that. It's just showing off now. The idea is get it out of this bucket as quick as you can. Very uncomfortable position. Not uncomfortable, you know, alien position. Who cares how smooth it is? It's all underwater anyway. And it's only a fucking day's work. Yeah, okay. Thank you. That's gone now. Not get any more out of that. Gee, oh, that's warm now.
Getting a bit of a sweat on doing that by hand. Not quite half, but almost. Right. Yeah, there's no more resin. Just need that to set hard now. And I can give it a kiss with a bit of paper. There's nothing more coming through there. I'm completely satisfied that that can be flow coated. I'm not going to get clever with the hand brushing on this one. Thank you very much.
Beautiful. Short and sweet.
A quick look at that. Quick look at it then before I put the clean the roller up. Any imperfections in it? Yes. Anything catastrophic? Nope. Again, let's have another look at it from out here. I'll ask Sean if he doesn't mind popping a picture over to me. Get that up somewhere sometime. Cheers.